try to take something there with you when you guys come out.
He came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old. From angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold. And peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all gracious King. The world in song still this late to hear the angels sing. Still through the cloven skies they come with peaceful wings unfurled, and still their heavenly music flows through all the weary world. In a man at war with man, hears not the love song which they bring. Oh, hush the noise and cease the strife, and hear the angels sing. Glory to God in the highest, glory to God evermore. Good news, great joy for all. Melody breaks through the silence. Christ the Savior is born. Jesus, the love song of God.
Glory to God evermore. Good news, great joy for all. Melody breaks through the silence. Christ the Savior is born. Jesus, the love song of God. Jesus. Jesus, the love song of God. You came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold.
All right, good evening.
Good evening.
And an early Merry Christmas to all of you. We're so thankful that you're here tonight. Welcome to Northside Community Church to one of our two Christmas Eve services. This one is more designated for children, which you may be able to tell with the number of kids that are sitting out in the audience tonight. I hope that we can all put on a kid-like spirit as this service goes through. It's going to be driven a lot to accommodate our children that are here tonight. But as is with most things, there's always a wonderful message in what our children are learning and what we're able to learn as well. I'm going to ask you to open up with me in a word of prayer, and then we'll continue on in the service. Heavenly Father, we are thankful to be in this place tonight. Thankful to hear all the little voices, all the older voices that are gathered in this place. Father, gathered here tonight to sing praises to you for who you are and for what you did so many years ago. Lord, we are reminded on nights like tonight of the beauty of Christmas. And Father, what that means for each of us, what that means for this entire world. So Lord, tonight we pray for your Holy Spirit to be in this place. We ask that in every way, you would be honored. You would be glorified by what's said and done. Bless everyone that's here tonight. Bless their families as they celebrate, as they come together, as they spend time together. Father, watch over them as only you can. And be with us in the remainder of our time together tonight. For it's in Christ's name that we pray. Amen. Amen. I'm going to invite Dee Belvin, our children's minister, to come up. And then I'm going to invite Lily Johnson, Bryson Freed, Sophia Wiggs, Aiden Allman, and Katie Shroud to come forward.
He will judge between the nations, and he will settle disrupt for many people. They will be beat their swords into plowshares, with the spears into pruning hooks. Nations will not take up swords against nations, nor will they train for wars anymore. Come, descendants of Jacob, let us walk in the light of the Lord. I have the candle of hope.
The candle of peace. Isaiah 11, 2 through 4. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of might, the Spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with the righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with his rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked.
Thumb part.
the candle of love. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
Candle of joy. Then the eyes of those who are blind will be open. The ears of those who can't hear will be unplugged. Those who can't walk will leap like a deer. And those who can't speak will shout with joy. Water will pour out in dry places. Streams will flow in the desert.
I have the Christ candle. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the shadow of death, a light has dawned.
I invite you to sing with us.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful, O ye nations, rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn. By highest heaven adore, Christ the everlasting Lord. Late in time, behold him come, offspring of a virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity. Man with men to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven Prince of Peace, hail Son of righteousness, light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mahilas is glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining till he appeared and the soul fell on its way. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh hear the angel voice. All night divine, all night when Christ was born, all night divine, all night, all night divine. And his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise, we let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Oh, praise his name forever. His power and glory evermore proclaim. His power and glory evermore.
One would have been the angel. One would have been the wise men. One would have been the shepherds. And so what we're going to invite you to do is to come down in groups. So if you got Mary or Joseph when you came in, I want you to all come right here where I am and come sit right next to me. If you got Mary or Joseph, come on down. Y'all just stay seated right here. Everybody just come sit right here in a corner. Okay, can y'all come up a little bit so we can make room for everybody? Okay, y'all can all be seated. Okay, if you got the shepherds, if you got a shepherd on your sheet of paper, you can come on forward. And if you have a shepherd, come stand right here, and then as soon as everybody gets up here, we'll sit down. Okay, if you got the angel, come on down, and we're going to get right in here. And if you got the wise men, you can come on down. Wise men, we're going to try and have you over here. So let them scoot through. Come on through right here, Bryce. Okay, that's okay. And last but not least, if you got the farm animals that were in the manger, come on down. All right, did we leave anybody out? If you didn't get a sheet of paper, come on and sit down with the rest of the group. It'll be fine. So how many of you guys have story time at your school or at home? Anybody, mom and dad, read you stories? So what I'm going to need you to do tonight is to listen really good, because I'm going to read you a story that's found in Scripture. And the story involves every single one of you and the sheets of paper that you're holding. And so if you're the shepherds, or if you're Mary and Joseph, or if you're the animals, or if you're the angel, or you're the wise men, I want you to listen to your part in the story. Because after we read it, I'm going to ask you a few questions. So you guys ready? Are you ready? All right, here we go. Make sure you're listening. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for a baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were so scared. But the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, and they began praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom His favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." And listen to this last part, guys. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. So I'm going to ask you guys some questions tonight based off the sheets of paper that you're holding. So I'm going to start with Mary and Joseph. All of you guys who are holding Mary and Joseph, what do you think Mary and Joseph packed for their trip? For this trip they were going on? Blankets? Some food? A cloth? Okay. What else do you think they packed? Bread? Water? What else? Anybody else thinks they packed stuff? Chicken? What'd you say? Water? Fish? Okay. How do you think they felt? You know, Mary and Joseph were told there was no room for them in the inn. How do you think they felt when they were told, when Mary was getting ready to have a baby, how do you think they felt they were when they were told there was no room for them? Sad? Sad? Angry? Disappointment? Mad? Worried? Yeah, I think they probably felt all of those things. So let me ask you, Matt, let me ask the shepherds then. Everybody who's got a shepherd sheet of paper. It says that the shepherds were living out in the fields nearby. What were the shepherds afraid of? Do you remember in the story? The angels, that's right. Do you think they were afraid of anything else? No, they were pretty tough, weren't they? They saw the angel and they were all of a sudden afraid. But you know what the Bible says? It says as soon as they went in and saw Jesus, they began to praise God. What are some of the ways that you guys praise God? For making the world and everything he's done. Bryson? Blessings? Luke? Praying. Praying? How about you guys? Singing? How else do we praise God? Lighting up candles? By making us? Praying? Let me ask you guys a question. It says that the angels talk to the shepherds. How would you guys feel if an angel talked to you? Scared? Surprised? Worried? See, you guys are kind of like the shepherds, aren't you? Y'all would have been afraid if the angels had shown up and started talking to you too. It could be. All right, so if you've got an angel sheet of paper, these questions are for you. So for the angels out there, it says that they came to bring good news. If you had good news to tell someone, how would you tell them? Telling them, how else would you tell people if you had really good news? Be excited for it? Yeah. Giving them a present? Making them cake? When you guys get really excited, how do you tell your friends or your parents that you're really excited about something? Okay. Got some future preachers on our hands that are going to be talking. Hey, let me ask you guys a question. What do you think the angel looked like? Any ideas? Look like God? Okay. What? Dressed in white? What else do you think the angel looked like? Was wearing white? Man with wings? Have you guys ever seen an angel before?
No.
Okay. You did. Okay. All right. All right. So the wise men. Let me ask you guys. Everybody that's holding up a wise man. If you can give baby Jesus anything, the Bible tells us that they were given gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. If you could give Jesus anything, what would you give him? Give him food. What would you give him? Water and drinks. Some toys. What kind of toys? Okay, a ball. What else would you guys give baby Jesus? A guitar? All right. Baby stuff. That would be a very practical gift. All right, hey, I've got one more question for you. This is for the animals. All right, so I want you guys to be really quiet because you guys have done a great job tonight. So listen to this last question. What do you think the animals thought when they saw Mary and Joseph come out to their house and have a baby in their house where they sleep? What do you think the animals thought of that? Happy? Excited? Sad? Have a playmate? All right. Okay. What else? Angry? Okay. Hey, listen, guys, as we wrap up, one of the things that you guys, I hope, will always remember is whether you're the shepherd or the angel or the wise man, is that God came into the world as a baby, as Jesus, for each and every one of you. He loves you so very much. And if you ever get to a place where you wonder if somebody loves you, who can you always remember who loves you? God, Jesus, He does. Jesus does, absolutely. And all the people that are sitting out there, moms and dads, grandparents, aunts and uncles, brothers and sisters, I'm pretty sure they love you too. You guys, hey, thank you so much. Take your pictures home, color them tonight, and maybe bring them back with you. Show me how good you guys can color, okay? All right. Hey, tell you what. You guys came down here so great. Could you go back to your seats just as good? All right. You guys can go ahead and go. You did. Good job. Good job. Bye-bye. One of the things, and we're gonna get ready to partake of the Lord's table here in a moment. One of the things that Scripture or that we're reminded in Scripture is to have the faith of a child. And when you see children who come down who aren't afraid to answer questions, sometimes questions that we ask people, questions that maybe we're asked ourselves at times, are questions that maybe we find a hard time answering. Max Licato once said that Christmas is best enjoyed when we approach it not with logic, but with imagination. And I think the best examples of that is found in children. We see how they approach this season and what all we can learn from them. Tonight, as we come to the table, we are doing something that Christ came into this world and as an adult told us we should model after Him. When Paul was writing the church at Corinth, he said that he received from the Lord what he was also passing on to them and to all of us, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, he broke it, and gave thanks and said, "This is my body, which has been broken for you. Eat this in remembrance of me." The Bible says that in the same way, after supper, he took the cup of the new covenant, and he says, "This is my blood, which has been shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Drink this in remembrance of me." How we observe communion at Northside is through a form called intinction. And that is, we invite all those who profess Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior to come to the table. Your child may be too young to have established that relationship, but what an awesome opportunity tonight for them to see that modeled in their parents or in their grandparents. Tonight I'm going to invite Eric and Dee to come forward and to help. But I also want to invite two children to come up and help as well. I want to invite Lainey Mathis and Matthew Wiggs to come up and help. before we partake of the bread and the cup tonight, we're going to have a word of prayer. So I'm going to ask you to pray with me. Father, we thank you for tonight. Thank you for the many blessings of life that you give to us. And Father, one of those blessings is the opportunity to follow you and to do what you have called us to do. Father, to imitate what you laid before your disciples and before the followers in the early church. Tonight, on this night of Christmas Eve, of celebrating your birth, of remembering all that you did by coming into this world as a child, Father, we are reminded of what that ultimately led to, which was a cross. Lord, tonight, as we symbolically remember that last conversation you had with your disciples, as we remember the last meal that you shared with them, Lord, we do so mindful of the calling that is upon each of our lives, the calling to pick up our cross, to follow you, perhaps even a calling to see this season with new eyes and a fresh vision. Lord, tonight as we remember what you've done, may we do so with glad hearts. May we do so giving thanks for all that you have done for us, recognizing that it began on a night much like tonight many years ago. Lord, we thank you for the promise of your word. We thank you for the hope that is found in Christ. And Father, we thank you for the opportunity in this time to remember. And Lord, we ask all of these things in Christ's name. Amen. Matthew, the body of Christ broken for you. Lainey, the body of Christ broken for you. Just put yours down, Eric. Eric, the body of Christ broken for you. D, the body of Christ broken for you. Thank you. Tonight, before we close, just a couple of things. One, I hope you have a Merry Christmas. I hope that in every way, even if it's been a challenge to get into the Christmas spirit this season, I hope that between tonight and tomorrow morning, you may find the imagination of what the Savior has done for us and how that impacts each and every one of us may rekindle anew a fresh vision of Christmas for you. The other thing that I would tell you tonight is I know that oftentimes at the early service, people are rushing out to get to various things. There's coffee and sweets in the lobby. If you've got some time to hang around and fellowship, we'd love for you to do that. And lastly, I hope you've got your candles ready. We're going to sing Silent Night, and what we're going to do is I'm going to walk down this aisle carrying a candle, and I'm going to light the candles on the outside aisles, and if you will just light the candles of the individuals next to you, please don't forget about our friends over here if you're on this end of the aisle. And then following Silent Night, Bill Powell, one of our elders, is going to give us the benediction. I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing together.
this many, many, many years ago. God gave up everything it meant to be God and was born in a manger so that he might live his life in a way that would reflect to us that we might find salvation and peace. This evening as we go from here, may God's blessing be with you. And as you share the good news with others, may people find Christ in this message tonight. As Tiny Tim said, God bless us, everybody.